Hello students, I hope you all are fine. So students, as you know, we are doing basic geometrical ideas chapter. So today our topic is circle and its parts. Okay, circle, you all are aware of circle and you are aware of some of its parts, but few parts are new for you. So let's start. So first part of circle is center. Center means where we keep our compass to draw the circle. That point is called center. Okay, so it's a point, and you know that point is a location. It is just location. So how we represent? We can represent with any alphabet. Okay, so I'm taking here O as center. So O is the center of the circle. Next is radius. So the line starting from center to the edge of the circle. So OF is also radius, OA is also radius, OA is also radius, and OB. All these are radii. Radii is the plural of radius. Okay, OA, OB, OE, OF. If you see, all are starting from O, means center. Okay, so next is diameter. Diameter is the line passing through the center. Okay, the line passing through the center and touches the edges of the circle at two points, A and B, and it is passing through center, O. Okay, it is mandatory to pass through center, only then it is diameter. So diameter is AB, A, B, but it is passing through O. Okay, so this is the diameter. Next is chord. Chord is any line segment which is meeting at two points at the edges of the circle. Now it is not compulsory to pass through center. Okay, chord. What is the difference between chord and diameter? Diameter always passes through the center. But chord, it is not compulsory. It may pass through the center or may not. Okay, so which are the chords in this figure? One is CD. Okay, because it has two ends at the edge of the circle, and AB. This is also chord. Okay, it may pass through the center or may not pass through the center. These two are chords of circle. You can draw anywhere. Okay. Next is arc. Now, bache, what is difference between, if you see, all these are line segments. But I have written here under the top, under the heading of arc. Now, what is arc? Arc is this one. This round portion. Okay, like CD is arc, this AB from this side or from this side, this is arc. AE is arc, AE, this one round portion on the circle, that is called arc. Or is it represent? How to represent this? So we put here arc symbol. This is arc symbol. Okay, so next is sector. These terms are new for you. Chord, arc, sector, segment. Okay, these are new for you. So next is sector. Sector is EOF. This EOF, shaded part. So if we shade this, so this part is called sector. So actually it is not any point, it is not any line segment, it is region. Region means space, area, region. Okay, so this region is enclosed from one side by the arc and from other sides 2 radii of the circle. What is sector? Again, I am repeating. It is the region or it is the space enclosed from one side by an arc. This is EF is the arc, and from other sides 2 radii of the circle. These are the radii of the circle. Okay, so this shaded part is called sector. Clear? Next is segment. Segment is this CD part, shaded part. Okay, this part which I am shading, this part is called segment. Segment is also a region. It's not any point, it's not any line segment. So it's a region enclosed by, from one side by the arc of the circle CD and second side by the chord of the circle. From one side it is enclosed by the arc and from the second side it is enclosed by the chord. Chord of the circle. So this CD portion is called segment. Okay. So next is, it is term circumference. What is circumference? The distance around the circle. This one, outer boundary, length of outer boundary. This is called circumference of the circle. Like in rectangle and square you have done perimeter, so similarly in circle we call it circumference, length of outer boundary. Okay, so I hope it is all clear to you. Thank you students, have a nice day.